Association rule mining. Basically, initially the term was not used as like the association rule mining. The term used was like the frequent pattern analysis. Okay, so frequent pattern mining or like the frequent pattern analysis. So in a way, what do you mean by the frequent patterns? So the pattern may be classified into items, or it may be a subsequence, or it may be a substructure. So in a way, like, as you know, in data mining, basically what we can have, we can process the structured data, the semi-structured data, and the unstructured data. So in a way, the example of like the structured data is like the items and the subsequences, and the unstructured or the semi-structured data is like, basically the example is substructure. So in that way, the frequent patterns. So where, what we do basically, we do search in a data set the patterns that occur frequently. So okay, so this is like what the problem statement is like, or what we are expected to do. So what we are expected to do, our goal is to find the frequent patterns. Means what? The patterns which are appearing frequently in the data set. Okay, so in a way, so from where this concept has come, so that concept was proposed by, in a research paper by Agarwal, Imelinsky, and Swami, and in the context of like the frequent items and the association rule mining. So in a way, so our focus is to find out the frequent item sets and to find out the association rules based on the frequent item sets. So in a way, what basically our motivation is, like, to finding the inherent regularities in the data, basically. So in that way, the applications of frequent or the association rule mining is basically the market basket analysis, cross marketing, catalog design, sell campaigning analysis, wake block analysis, and the DNA sequence analysis, basically. So in that way, what we can say, the market basket analysis may be the example of like the item mining, the web log analysis, or like the click stream analysis, or like the web mining, web sequence mining. Basically, this is like the specialized area of the data mining, basically. So web mining is a specialized area, and here in the frequent pattern mining, sequence mining, or like the web sequence mining, is a specialized area. So where we do consider this second type, the subsequences are considered, basically. And the third example of like what, it is a DNA sequence analysis. Okay, so where the DNA structures are analyzed, basically. So in that way, that comes into the category of like the substructure analysis. Okay, so in that way, what we do have, basically the specialized areas are also there for the association rule mining, but here in our curriculum we do have only the focus for like what, the frequent pattern mining, or like the, it is called as also the frequent item set mining. So we do have only the focus on the frequent item set mining, and for that frequent item set mining only the a priori algorithm and the FP growth algorithms work. Basically, for subsequences, for the substructures, again there are many other algorithms are there based on the a priori and the FP growth. So in that way, what we can say, the, this is like a research field where many more algorithms are now evolved based on the basic algorithms in association rule mining, which are a priori and the FP growth algorithm. So in that way, and these are the applications, basically. So in that way, why this frequent pattern mining or the association rule mining is an important task, is an important task in data mining. Because in a way, like, if we see, there are only three techniques are there, only three major class techniques are there in the data mining. One is association rule mining, second one is classification, and third one is clustering. Okay, so in that way, basically the classification is a supervised model, then clustering is the unsupervised model. Then what is basically, why the association rule mining is one of the important tasks in the data mining, as the association rule mining also may be used in the classification and the clustering techniques. So means what? These frequent patterns, the association rules which are generated, they may be used basically as one of the technique in the classification and the clustering also. So in that way, the frequent pattern mining or the association rule mining plays the major role in the data mining techniques. Okay, so in that way, so where it is useful basically, so using the frequent pattern mining, what we can do, we can find out the associations, we can find out the correlations, and we can find out the casualties also. So in that way, the association rule mining or the frequent pattern mining can be used for finding out the associations among the data set, finding out the correlations among the data set. So in that way, this is the first use of the frequent pattern mining. Then the another use is basically what we can do, we can apply the frequent pattern mining or the association rule mining techniques to the item sets, the normal item sets which we have discussed. Then we can apply it to the sequential patterns, to the structural patterns like the graphs, like the videos, like the audios. So all those comes under like the structural analysis. So in that way, the association rule mining is categorized into three areas. One is frequent item set mining. Second one is frequent sequential mining. And third one is frequent structural pattern mining. Okay. So this is basically the broad categorization or like the broad classification of the association rule mining task, out of which we are going to focus only on the item set mining. Okay. Then the third area of usage for the frequent association rule mining is pattern analysis in spatio-temporal data set, in the multimedia data set, in the time series data set, and in a stream data set. So in the first introductory unit, we had discussed about like which are the various types of data sets which we can use in data mining applications. So there we discussed about like what there are like the spatio-temporal data sets are also there, the multimedia data sets are also there, the time series data set also are there, the stream data sets are also there, along with the normal numeric data set. So in that way, the association rule mining can be applied to these specialized data sets too. Okay, but this is not the scope of our syllabus. Then as I discussed, the frequent pattern mining or like the association rule mining, the association rules which are generated basically, they are used as an input to the classification technique also. So the classification technique which uses the association rules is called as the rule-based classification technique. Rule-based classification technique. So that we are going to discuss in the fifth unit. So in our curriculum, fifth unit and the sixth unit are belonging to the classification. Okay. So in that way, association rule mining can be used as one of the technique of for the in the classification also. Okay. Then it is also used as an input to the cluster analysis also. So in that way, we can form the cluster based on like the patterns which are associated with each other, which are correlated with each other. So those patterns we can club as a one cluster in the clustering applications. So in that way, the frequent pattern mining or the association rule mining can be used in the classification techniques as well as like in the clustering analysis. Okay. So on a similar line, the applications of the association rule mining are in the cube generation also, in the cube generation also in OLAP, okay, in the online analytical processing. So that is like a part of like the data warehousing, the data warehousing. So where what we can have basically, when we are computing the cubes, we are computing the cubes. The cubes can be, should be computed based on like certain criteria, certain thresholds. So in that way, there we can definitely use the association rules as a base. So in that way, in the data warehousing, in the cube computations also, we can use the association rule mining. Okay. So on a similar line, the other applications are semantic data compression. So there also the frequent pattern mining or the association rule minings can be used basically. So there are variety of applications are there where the association rule mining is used. So in a way, now to have basically the recommender system, okay, the recommender system, if we have like the more applications to discuss, okay, then in the recommender system, if I am developing the app for recommending to based on the customer's behavior pattern, the customer's behavior pattern, then there also I can go with these three types of the association rule mining I can use basically. That is like what, based on like what are the transactions the customer has done for last 6 months, based on like the hotel transactions, the airline transactions. So based on that, I can do the item set. I can do the item set association rule mining. Okay. So where based on the frequent patterns, I can recommend basically, I can analyze the customer's behavior, customer's liking, and I can definitely recommend him or her the various options for like the, if I'm going for the food, then I can decide on like what frequently he has ordered earlier basically, or she has ordered earlier. Based on that, definitely I can recommend something. So in that way, the item set mining can be used in the recommender system. On a similar line, the sequence mining. So what may be the, what I can do based on the previous history of a customer, what I can analyze the sequence, the pattern in which the customer has visited the online shopping websites. So there definitely the sequence is considered for the, in which the manner in which the customer has visited the various websites for basically the shopping, online shopping. So she might have visited the Amazon, then after Amazon, the Myntra, after Myntra, there are many more basically, which you are more aware of than me. So in that way, so for that basically, the sequence is generated, and based on the sequences are compared, and based on the sequences, the frequent sequence patterns are decided, and based on that, the recommendations are done basically. On a similar line, the example, the recommendation system example can be given for the structural frequent mining. So on the geographic locations basically, so from which locations she has ordered, number of times, based on that also the decisions may be taken. So in a way, this is like a vast area of applications are there for the association rule mining. Basically, the data mining field evolved, the evolution for the data mining field itself is from the market basket analysis. So what is it basically, market basket analysis? This is the popular application which was like, when in the early age of like in the 90s in the foreign countries, basically when there was like the evolution of like the supermarkets, and then there they felt like basically now it's a age of like the online transactions, and there where we can analyze what are the transactions. So where there is no use of like the database, there are the limitations of the database management system, and there they felt like what we can do, we can preserve the huge historical data, and based on the huge historical data, what we can do basically, we can give the, or we can recommend to the customer basically, or we can recommend to the supermarket people also what they should buy based on the likings of the customers basically. So which items are frequently purchased together, so those patterns, because like in the databases using the database management system, we can't give the recommendations with the which are the frequent patterns basically which are purchased together in a supermarket. Okay, so in a way basically the evolution of the data mining field itself is started from a very first application, that is market basket analysis. Okay, so that is like the very first application from where the data mining field evolved, and the evolution is with like the association rule mining basically. Okay, so in a way so what we discussed about like what are the key terminologies. Now I want in the chart window, okay, what we are going to discuss in this unit, what is association rule mining and what is frequent pattern mining. Okay, now what I want, which three types of data set which we can consider for association rule mining, I want the answer in the chart window. I told you three types of data sets which we can consider for the association rule mining. Okay, they are common data set, that is item set mining. Second one is sequential frequent pattern mining, and third one is the structural pattern mining, of which we are going to focus only on the frequent item set mining. So in a way we had discussed with the applications also. Now we will go with the basic concepts. So the basic concepts might have covered in the data analytics, but now here also we will cover it basically. So now what is our focus? The association rule mining actually can be viewed as two-step process. Okay, so for any of the algorithm, for the a priori or for like the FP growth or for any of the other extended algorithm based on the a priori and the FP growth, association rule mining is a two-step process basically. So in first step, what we do basically, we find all the frequent item sets, and for that what parameter we use as a threshold, we use the minimum support value as a threshold basically. So which are the frequent item sets or which are the frequent patterns, the item sets or the patterns which satisfy the minimum support condition, they are called as frequent patterns or frequent item sets. So what we use the terminology as either the frequent patterns or the frequent item sets. Okay, so for association rule mining, it's a two-step process. One is finding all frequent item sets or all frequent patterns. So that is called as frequent one pattern, frequent two pattern, frequent three pattern, frequent four pattern, frequent one item set, frequent two item set, frequent three item set, frequent four item set. So n number of basically based on the length of the data set basically. Okay. So in that way, the very first step for the association rule mining is finding all frequent item sets. So finding the frequent item sets is based on like what? The criteria of the minimum support. The criteria of the minimum support. Then the second step for the association rule mining is based on the frequent patterns or based on the frequent item set, we are expected to generate the strong association rules. So the second step is generating strong association rules from the frequent item set. Okay. So how we decide which rules are strong association rules? So for that, again, the condition is we use is the minimum confidence measure. So in that way, the association rules which satisfy the criteria of the minimum support and the minimum confidence, those association rules we can say as like the strong association rules. Okay. So in that way, association rule mining is a two-step process where the first step is like we are expected to search the frequent item set, and the second step is based on the minimum support threshold value, and the second step is to generate the association rules. So in that way, association rule mining is a two-step process. So in a way, now what basic thing is required basically? Okay, so in that way, again I am repeating, association rule mining is a two-step process. The first step is to find the frequent patterns, or it is also called as frequent item set, from the given database. And the second step is like what? From the frequent patterns, using the minimum confidence threshold value, we are expected to generate the association rules. So these two steps now we are going to discuss. So first, what we will do today, we will take one general example and then we will move to the algorithmic aspect. So in a way, we have discussed about like what we are searching for. We are searching for the rules where there are the positive association, there is a positive correlation. So in a way, basically, now in a class, we can take one more example. In a class, we are a group of students basically. But then what we do establishing the association with whom? With the students of a similar nature, and they, we call it as like a friends basically. So in a way, like inherently in our nature, what we do stay with our student friends, those to whom we can say we do have the similar likings, or we do feel comfortable with the students, those we call them as a friends basically. So in that way, what we can say, the best example of like the association rule mining is like what? Whatever the relations, whatever the friendship we do with our student colleagues. Okay, so in that way, that is like the inherent. So there we don't apply any condition, but inherently we are applying the condition of like what? These are like the minimum conditions. Based on that, what I can say, she can be my friend or he can be my friend. And based on that, we do again apply like what? Now the support, the minimum condition is fulfilled. Now I want to go with like some additional conditions for like for establishing the association, the long-term association. So again, certain additional thresholds we do apply, and based on that, like what we do get as a result, the long-term association as being the friends. So this is like what here we are not applying any technical aspect when we do make the friends basically, but inherently inside we are judging, and we are judging the people, and then we are making the friends. So in that way, this is like what the one more example I can say basically of the association rule mining. Okay, so in a way now we will go with like the actual stuff, and we will go with the one basic example, one simple example. Okay, so only this example today I will cover, and then in the next lecture we will start with the actual a priori algorithm. So here now we are not applying any algorithm. Okay, just what we are getting cleared, we are getting cleared the basic concepts, we are getting cleared the basic concepts. So here for the association rule mining, what is the input? Input is a database. Input is a database. So this is a normal database basically, where we have the transaction ID and the items bought by that particular customer. So in that way we may observe basically the transaction IDs are there and the transactions are there. Okay, so in that way this database is the input to the association rule mining. Then the next step is basically what we do, convert this database into the data set, and then from the data set we do go with like finding the frequent patterns, and then we do find the association rules. So in that way what we do have basically in this case, now our objective is to find all the association rules where X is associated with Y with the condition of minimum support and minimum confidence. So minimum support is the another input, minimum support threshold is one input, minimum confidence threshold is another input, and the third input is like the database itself. So to the association rule mining we do have three inputs. One is the original database, then the second is minimum support threshold value, and the third one is minimum confidence threshold value. So in that way we need three inputs for association rule mining. Okay, then what is basically the support measure and the confidence measure? So in that way support measure S is like what probability that a transaction contains X as well as Y, X union Y. So in that way, in how many transactions basically milks and nuts are there. So in that way the support is calculated, the support is calculated basically. Then what is confidence? It's a conditional probability basically, it's a conditional probability. So you know basically what is conditional probability. So in how many transactions, if item X is there, then out of those transactions, in how many transactions Y is also there. So in that way the confidence is measured basically. So for example, to calculate the confidence basically, so if we take the case of basically milk. Okay, so here in this example, in how many transactions milk is appearing? In three transactions milk is there. So we do consider only three transactions for like the confidence measure basically. So if we want to check the confidence of milk and nuts, so in that way out of three transactions only in one transaction nuts are there, only in one transaction nuts are there. So in that way the confidence is calculated. Okay, so that is basically what is support So in how many transactions that item is appeared basically. So that is support. And confidence is like what? The conditional probability we do basically. So in that way, we don't use confidence in the first step. We do use only the support in the first step for finding the frequent patterns basically. So in that way, here the frequent patterns are calculated. So again, what I stated, the two terminologies are used. One is frequent item set or other is frequent pattern. So in that way, here the frequent pattern terminology is used. So these are basically frequent one patterns. Why they are called as frequent one patterns? Because like the individual counts are there basically. So in that way, frequent one patterns basically. So in that way, how we can calculate basically the support for the individual items? So just the count of like the appearance in the number of transactions. So in that way, milk is appearing in 3 transactions. So the milk support is 3. Then nuts appearing in again 3 transactions. So nuts support is 3. Diapers are appearing in 4 transactions. 1, 2, 3, 4. So diaper support is 4. X is 3. So X are 3. So these are frequent one patterns. The frequent one patterns. So this is the support of like. Then milk and diaper together they are appearing in how many transactions in all? So that is the support for like the frequent two patterns. So milk diaper are in together in three transactions. So in that way milk diaper in 3 transactions. So in that way actually we are expected to calculate all the frequent patterns, that is frequent one pattern, frequent two patterns, frequent 3 pattern and frequent 4 patterns, as like the maximum length of the transaction is 5. Okay, so in a way we are expected to, and then once we are calculating, so here how we decide whether it is a frequent pattern or not. So in that way the minimum support should be 50%. So here how many transactions are there? Total 5 transactions are there. So minimum support 50% is 2.5. So in that way, as it is 2.5, either we can consider minimum support as 2 or minimum support as 3. So here if we consider minimum support as 3, then what we can have basically, why we have not considered here the sugar? Why we have not considered here the sugar? As sugar is not a frequent pattern, as it is appearing only in 2 transactions. Sugar is appearing only in 2 transactions. So in that way, it's not a frequent pattern. Okay. So only the items which are having the minimum support value more than 50%, that is more than 3. So those patterns are called as like the frequent patterns. So here in this example, we have not considered sugar. Okay, then again, we have not considered coffee. Coffee again, it is appearing twice only. So we have not considered. So we have considered only the items which are having the support more than or equal to 3. And in that way, the frequent patterns are calculated. Then the next step is like what? Now from these frequent patterns, we have to search for whether the association rules are with the confidence measure, we are expected to calculate the association rules. So in that way, this association rule calculation we will see in the next session. Now just what we have discussed, what is support, what is confidence, what is minimum support, what is minimum confidence, and how to generate the frequent patterns based on the threshold value of the minimum support. So with this, now I will stop today my session. Again with the same example, in the next session we will continue, and then with the algorithmic steps of the a priori algorithm, we will go by solving the association rule mining problem. So in this unit, what is important, you should be able to write the pseudocode, because the pseudocode is asked in the example. You should be able to write the basic definitions like the relative support, absolute support, actual support, actual confidence, then the minimum support value, minimum confidence value, then the strong association rules. All these terminologies are also asked in the examination. Then the problems are also asked for the a priori and for the FP group. So we will go step by step. So just today we have done the basic introduction to the association rule mining. We discussed with the applications also, and we just tried to solve only one simple example. So with this now, thank you for your patient listening. If any queries are there, you are expected to unmute your mic and you are expected to ask the questions, and we will continue in the next session for the data mining. With this, I will conclude my session. Thank you all.